Good morning, friends. It's so nice to have you back on this beautiful Saturday. And I am so glad that you would take a few minutes and spend it with me to learn some great things about energy boosting foods. I can't wait to come see you through the comments. So if you're here, say hello. And we're excited to be with you today. As always, this is Anitra and with Simply Living Smart. And today we're going to be talking about some great ways to boost your energy naturally. Now, I am so thankful all the time to hear your stories. I love how you're sharing what you learn with others. And all week I've been hearing some great feedback and learning how you're sharing what you're learning here. And it just gives me such joy, and I hope that's always going to be my hope, is that you take what you learn here and you go out into the world and share it with the people that you love, so that we can just be more knowledgeable, make better choices, and just have more joy in our lives altogether. So I am so happy to have you along. Today we have a lot to talk about. I'm going to try to do this in 30 minutes, so hold on with me. When we're talking about energy boosting foods, I think, wow, we're at a time now where the pandemic is finally lifting after all this time, and we're able to get out more, plan more things outside, hiking, camping, whatever we're going to do. And we need energy boosting foods. I think sometimes we focus so much on the meals that we eat and having healthy food at home to just eat regular meals. But how often do we really talk, we think about what are we gonna eat when we're energy fueling and snacking? And that seems to be a very common thing that we're doing these days. So I wanna give you some ideas. A lot of them you may already know, but these are gonna be maybe some little secrets that you don't. So I wanna dive in, and I wanna talk about mainly things like seeds and nuts and dates, dried fruit, oats, some grains, things like that, that you probably already have on hand anyway. So if you have comments, feel free to share those in the comment box. If you come late, just know that you can leave a comment, and if I don't address it in this episode, I will certainly go after the class and I will answer those comments for you, those questions that you have. So let's dive in. One of the best things that we can do to strengthen our immune system, pandemic or not, is to eat healthy, and we know this. And so I feel like, you know, when we can focus on things that are easy to do, that don't take a lot of time, then we're going to probably be more successful. And I find, maybe you do too, that when you learn something and you share it with someone else, that you're much more motivated to keep doing that thing. And so it kind of creates a habit in your life. And so when I learn new recipes, I love to make them and share them with others, because I feel like when they're happy and they love it, I want to keep doing it more. So today we're going to talk about things like power oatmeal, all natural energy bars, sesame crisps, puddings, and more. And I want to let you know that I have all these recipes that I'm going to let you download. So as soon as this is over, I'll put the link in the comment box, and you're welcome to highlight that, download it, and use it as you wish, and share it with anyone you want. It's totally free to you. So let's start with breakfast. Now, I happen to be I love breakfast food, although I don't eat breakfast at breakfast time. I kind of like to eat breakfast foods later in the evening or after a long bike ride. So they're comfort food, and they can be refreshing as well. So let's start with one of the things that's the most common for people these days, and that's oatmeal. So we're going to talk about this overnight oats. Doesn't this look delicious? This is my pineapple, coconut, blueberry overnight oats. And in the recipes that I'm going to share with you, there are all kinds of recipes for overnight oats. There's things like peanut butter and jelly and tropical, and just some yummy combinations that you're going to love. And really the basis to overnight oats is simply oats, rolled oats, and almond milk or any kind of nut milk, some Greek yogurt, and chia seed or flaxseed. You can do it in the same container. You don't have to have any special tools. So all you're gonna do is just take your glass, and you're going to put your oats in it. I put about 1/4 cup. And then you're going to add 2 tablespoons of Greek yogurt, some nut milk of your choice, and 1 tablespoon or so of flax and chia seed. Mix it all up. It does get thick pretty quickly. And then you're going to just leave it there overnight. Now, I like to do all my add-ins the next day or when I'm ready to eat. So, for example, pineapple or blueberries or bananas or peanut butter, just swirl it in there. And that is yummy. The thing I love about overnight oats is that it's cold and it's so refreshing and it's chewy and just really, really good. So it just helps me feel like I'm getting real packed nutrition and I haven't spent really any time. And you can do these ahead of time. You can do 5 or 6 at a time and have them in the fridge. They last for well over a week. So it's really, really yummy. Now, if you like your oatmeal hot, then you can make these things I do. They're little oatmeal packets. This happens to have protein powder instead of powdered milk, but you can use powdered milk if you want. I have some freeze-dried yogurt, and this happens to be strawberry yogurt that I have in here, so it gives it a nice little taste. And then just some oats and a little bit of chia and hemp. Now, let's talk about oats, because when we talk about oats, a lot of people say, well, what's the difference between steel-cut oats, rolled oats, quick oats? Oats come in 4 different forms, and they come as the whole grain, and then they're processed and processed and processed until you get to the quick oats. So when we're doing steel-cut oats is the next version right down from the whole grain. Now, if you're storing oat groats, which is the whole grain that looks like wheat, you can actually store that for 25 years in a cool, dry place, and you can grind it to make your own oat flour. When you're making these oatmeal packets, I would recommend that you put in some oat flour because it helps it to be a little bit more creamy and a little bit more just a nicer texture. So we have the oat groat, which is the whole oat, and then you have the steel cut oat, which is just cracked 4 times. So it's a little bit processed, but not too much. And you can use steel cut oats even in your overnight oats or in your quick oats if you want. Just make sure to, they're just gonna be a little bit chewier. So be prepared for that texture. The next process down is rolled oats. So that the oat groat has just been rolled flat. Those are still great nutrition. They probably have a 3-year shelf life. And then you have your quick oats that have maybe a 1-year shelf life. Not the best nutrition. So I would steer away from quick oats if you can and stick more with the oat groats or the rolled oats. Okay, so you know, these packets are really forgiving. You can put whatever you want, whether that's raisins or nuts or cinnamon. Just make it really your own and you're gonna love it because it's gonna just be your favorite. All right, so we've talked a little bit about oatmeal. Now, oatmeal, of course, is really high in fiber, so it's so good for regulating blood sugar, keeping you full longer. And I love, again, just that chewy texture of oatmeal. Let's talk about 2 of the other ingredients that I absolutely love and really are the base to any overnight oats or things like chia pudding, and those are chia and flax. So these 2 are power foods. They are superfoods. And let's start with chia. So chia goes back to the Aztecs. I mean, it goes back so many years, and it's really called strength food or runner's food for a reason, because it gives you such good energy. Now, both of these should be stored long-term in the freezer for optimal freshness. So chia seed can just be used whole. You can put it in all kinds of things, smoothies and sweetbreads and chia puddings, things like that. My favorite chia pudding is just, you know, a quarter cup of, or maybe 2 tablespoons of chia is all I use. And then a good squirt of honey or maple syrup, teeny tiny bit of salt, some blueberries, and then some almond milk, and just let it sit overnight. And it's creamy and yummy. It tastes like dessert. It tastes like it should be so naughty. But chia is great. Now, chia actually retains 10 times its weight in water. So you can see how when the chia swells in your body, it's kind of a flusher. It flushes toxins out of the colon, and it's very good for you. So what it does, it has lots of omega fats, it has protein, it's just such good nutrition. Again, it's a superfood, but what it does when it expands, and you want to make sure that you drink water or liquids with it, is it'll help to flush all those toxins out, and it'll help you just feel better in your tummy. So if you're somebody who who experiences bloating, chia might be a great way to help you get rid of that bloating. Now, chia and flax can be used for something really unique, and that is a chia or flax egg. So some of you out there are vegan and don't like to use eggs. So what you can do instead is you can take a tablespoon of either ground flax or chia seed, combine it with 3 tablespoons of water, give it a good stir, let it sit there for 5 minutes, and you'll notice that it's turned into this beautiful little gel. And this beautiful little gel is equal to 1 egg. So you can use that in any of your baking, whether that's breakfast or breads or pancakes or anything like that. So it's a nice way to stay vegan and have some great nutrition. Now, I love to use flax in my homemade bread, especially my wheat breads, because sometimes when you make wheat bread and you don't have enough protein, let's say, in your wheat, then it can be a little bit dense. But what I do is I add about 1/4 cup of flaxseed, ground flaxseed, to my bread dough as it's going, and it makes it so soft and so lofty, and the texture is just chewy and yummy. So another way that you can really give loft to your bread, just so you know, is you can put 2 hard vitamin C capsules in your flour mill and grind that all together with your wheat, and it's the ascorbic acid in it that really gives it that loft and that yummy texture. Now, you want to make sure that, like I mentioned, you freeze or you refrigerate your flaxseed, and you want to buy the flaxseed whole. Why? Because it retains so much more nutrition that way. So buy it in seed form, and then invest in a nice little coffee grinder. I just have this little Krupp's coffee grinder, and it's perfect because whenever I need, I do about 1 month worth of flax meal, that's the ground flax, at a time, and I leave the rest in the freezer. So what I'll do is I'll take some, put it in this little coffee grinder, push the button, it'll whir around, and it's this beautiful flax powder, and then I'll store it in my refrigerator. Now, again, you can use this for anything. If you want to do flax eggs, if you want to do any baking in any of your oatmeals or cereals, it's just a great addition to your everyday meal and such an energy booster. Now, flaxseed is also good for people who are going through menopause. It helps to kind of curb those symptoms of menopause, hot flashes, things like that. So look into how flax can really help you if you're in that stage of life, okay? All right, so we've talked about chia, we've talked about flax. Those are kind of the basics of really nutritional foods as far as breakfast foods or snack foods. And we're gonna dive into snacks in just a minute. All right, so let's see if I've missed anything at all. Oh, yes. Another reason that I love to use flax is that it's a thickener. So if you, let's say you make a soup, and your soup is just more runny than you want, just take some flaxseed, just some ground flaxseed, put it in your soup. You don't have to mix it with water or milk or anything. Just throw it in there and it just dissolves, and it just because it kind of expands and becomes jelly, it will thicken your soup naturally and you will never notice. This is really good, I think, for minestrones that can be a little bit, way too runny sometimes. It just gives it kind of a more hearty texture. Another thing I love to use flax on is in my applesauce. So I like to eat applesauce right before I go to bed for some reason. And I like to have flax in it because it has kind of that nutty flavor. And it makes me feel just like I'm just full in a really good way. And it doesn't make you feel sick full, just content full. And so things like that where it's really easy to, add it to yogurt, it's salads. I mean, just be really creative. Flax doesn't really have a taste. It just feels kind of nutty. But it's delicious. You can make homemade, flax crackers or seed crackers. And it just, so anyway, I could go on about flax. One of my favorite things, because when you buy natural peanut butter, you'll notice that the peanut butter is really oily on top and then it's really dry on the bottom, right? So you always have to go in there and mix it with a spoon. Well, you can try this little trick. Take 1 tablespoon or 2 of ground flaxseed, put it in your nut butter, give it a really good stir, and it will not be runny again. And it'll just have that nice consistency, that creamy, jiffy consistency that's just really nice to have. And then your kids will want to eat natural peanut butter more often than Jif peanut butter. So that's a really good tip as well. All right, so moving on from flax, let's talk about, hi, Lori, nice to see ya. Love having my friends on. Okay, let's talk about another time-saving energy booster that you can plan for ahead of time, and that is protein. Now, so many people think that you can only get protein through meat, and that's just a fallacy. It's not true, and it doesn't have to be. I happen to not be a meat eater, so I need to get my protein in other ways, and I've gone like for months without eating really a lot of protein. And when I have a boost of protein, I can tell immediately that I have more energy, I sleep better, I feel better. So it's here to stay for me. Now that I'm almost 50, I think I need to really ramp up my protein. And I do it in a natural way. So for me, I use this pea protein. I'm sure all of you have seen this. This is Orgain, and it's a pea protein, so it's totally vegan. And it comes in vanilla or chocolate. So what I do to save a little time, instead of getting in here and then, you know, putting all my fruit and all my greens in the blender every single day and foraging in my fridge, what I do is I just take a little sandwich bag like this, and I will do 10 of these at a time. And it all starts with my greens. So I take really big fat bunch, handful of kale or collard greens or spinach, shove them in the bottom of my bag. And then I put 2 scoops of protein and then whatever else you want. I like to use flax and hemp seed. I do 1/4 teaspoon of matcha powder. And then you can put in frozen blueberries or your bananas that are going bad that I've put in the freezer so that I can use them, or anything like that, strawberries, just be creative, whatever you love. That way, when you're ready for a protein boost, all you have to do is go in your freezer, get the bag, put it in your blender, add either water like I do, or you can do any kind of nut milk, and then it's just instant deliciousness. Now, here's another tip. I know a lot of times when I do protein shakes, they're just kind of really runny and they just grainy and I mean, not my favorite texture. So I like them a little bit thicker. And instead of adding a bunch of ice, and that makes it so cold, I can hardly drink it for an hour, I will actually freeze my avocado in 2 quarters, and I will put 1/4 of an avocado in my protein bag. And then that automatically acts like a thickener and an ice, you know, ice machine, and you have a really super thick smoothie. So it's really nice, and you get your healthy fats. So that's a really great tip as well. Okay, I think the more we can help our kids, you know, be healthy and maybe boost their nutrition as well. I mean, I don't know of any kid who's going to go into the fridge and eat a handful of kale, right? So if we can make these protein packets and just show them where they're at and how yummy they're going to be, and just do it for them, put all that nutrition they need, the flax, the chia, the hemp, everything, the fruit and the protein, all in one, all they have to do is add water and stir, and it's a no-brainer. So, okay, there you go. And this can be any time of day. Some kids do really well having some protein before bed. It'll help them kind of sleep better, and it'll help them in the morning feel more energized. So I think that might be something you could consider. All right. One of the things I really want to focus on today are nuts and seeds. Now, I normally would go into Sprouts or Whole Foods and buy my nuts and my seeds and my dates and things like that. But I've learned that I pay so much more going to those places, even if I'm buying them in a bulk container, than going on Amazon. I have found such good, and I'm super picky, reputable companies that sell nuts and seeds, dates, Whole Foods. And so I'm going to share those with you, and I'm also going to put them in the notes if you want to read that later. But the ones I like the best are Sincerely Nuts, Gerbs, G-E-R-B-S, Delish, and Spicy World. I think those are my absolute favorites. They're so fresh. Nothing is broken. They package them really well. And I buy them in big bags, like maybe 3 to 5 pound bags. I freeze most of it, and then I put the other ones in a container like this. I only use about 2 cups, and you can see all these here at a time. These are what sit in my pantry, and then I just replenish them as I need them. But it's great because when you see your food, you're more likely to use it. And it's nice to have on hand. So again, freezing it just lengthens the shelf life. And so it's nice to have those around. But check out those brands, because I buy every nut. I can find them roasted or raw. They're just super top quality. All right. Now, what about nuts and seeds? Why are those so good for energy? I mean, they have lots of fiber. Research shows that if you eat 1/4 cup every day of nuts or seeds or a combination of both, your heart's going to be healthier, your joints are going to be healthier, your blood sugar is going to be better, you're going to be able to maintain your weight better. So there are all kinds of reasons to eat these foods. Really good for your heart. All right, so I'm going to dive into this ebook. First of all, I want to remind you that I'm giving you this ebook. This is Overnight Oats 5 Ways, and you're going to be able to download this at the end of the session. But this is great. It has all kind of great recipes that you're going to want to try. So the second one I have for you is Yummy No Bake Energy Favorites. This is what it looks like. And these have my absolute yummiest little treats. So we're going to start with the first one, and that is my Nutty Bars. Now, this is so easy to make, and I feel like if we have a plan ahead of time, then we just execute better. And again, if you want to make the recipe and share it, you're going to be a fan for life of these. These are so good. I'm going to show them to you up close. So you can see this has almonds, pistachios, walnuts, craisins, hemp seed, chia seed. I mean, it's just loaded with stuff. Doesn't that look good? And it's so easy to make. So all you do is you choose whichever nuts you want. You can pick any combination. Just put them in a big pan on top of your stovetop, or you can even roast them in the oven, dry, no oil, no butter, nothing. And just roast them for 5 or 6 minutes till they're really toasty. If you put in sesame seeds, they'll brown really fast, so maybe roast on a lower temperature. Once they're nice and golden, turn them off. While they're roasting, you're gonna wanna get a smaller pan and you just put together this super, super easy gooey filling. And you can use any sweetener you want. I prefer honey and half brown sugar, and it's very little. It's like a quarter of a cup. So it's not very much. A pinch of salt and then a little bit of vanilla. And just get that nice and bubbly. Like let it bubble away for 3 or 4 minutes. It doesn't have to be caramely staged. It doesn't have to be, you don't have to check the temperature. But as long as it's really bubbly and caramely, you turn it off. You pour it over this nut mixture, give it a nice stir, make sure everything's sticky and really incorporated. And then what I do for the nut bars is I will take this cheesecake pan. The only reason I use a cheesecake pan, it has a really nice lip, and then I can just take the rim off, and what's left is just, the bar. And the reason I like this is because I like my bars to be thicker than my sesame crisps. We're gonna talk about sesame crisps in a minute. But you see that they're pretty thick. And so if you can, get something that's wide, even a bar pan, and you can either lightly butter the bottom or you can put parchment inside. That way it gives you a nice thick bar. Then when you go to cut it, maybe 2 hours later, it takes a while because it's super, super hot and it's sticky. I like to take one of these little, I don't know what they're even called, a little chopper, or you can take a big knife. I think I have more control over this because I can just push right on. And you can cut them in this size or you can cut them in smaller sizes. I like to leave the parchment on the back because then if I'm storing them in a container, then they don't stick to one another. And these are great. I mean, these can last up to a month, just in a nice airtight container or plastic bag. And they are so good. So what I do with these is I actually put lime juice in them. And lime juice gets it just that little bit of a tangy, yummy, zesty taste. So the honey and the lime is just delicious. So you'll have to give these a try. They're very, very easy to make. And you can make a big batch. And they're fun to give as little gifts. Just put them in a bag, put a bow on it, and give it to your neighbor. But what I love about these is they're such good energy fuel for runners, bikers, hikers. It instantly gives you that boost. It's interesting because I've tried all kinds of bars and, energy fuels, gums, gels, whatever. And I can't get over the fact that some of them I can't articulate what those are. I can't even pronounce the words or the ingredients that are in those things. So I just think, you know what? After I eat those, I don't know if this is your experience, but I feel really bloated and uncomfortable. And I just think it's all the fillers they put inside, as natural as they say they are. So I've decided that I just make my own. So whether it's these nutty bars or the date balls or the sesame crisp I'm going to show you, I get instant energy and I feel great. I mean, it literally, it's like an infusion of just brightness and energy, and it's wonderful. And it's all natural. I know exactly what went into it because I made it. So we have to just be mindful of what works for us. All right. So now we talked about nutty bars. Let's talk about sesame crisps. Okay, these, my friends, are one of my absolute favorite thing. They have sesame seeds, and sesame seeds are so good for you. Again, one of those high omega-3 foods, but pumpkin seeds as well. So I take some pumpkin seeds and just a big, like probably 3 or 4 cups worth, and I put them in my pan. And I let them toast. Again, same thing. It's the same thing. A little bit of honey, a little bit of brown sugar, some salt. I mix it all around. And then these I actually put onto a parchment paper. Make sure that you lightly spray your parchment paper. And then I take a wet fork so it doesn't stick, and I just kind of tamp it down so it fills that all of that parchment paper from end to end. Then I put another layer of lightly sprayed parchment paper on top of that. And then I take my rolling pin and I just roll it out so it's super, super, super thin. And really, it just looks like candy out of a store. It's really, really nice looking. And then so I shore up the edges while it's still warm and pliable. And then I let that sit maybe 10, 15 minutes. I want it to still be warm when I cut it, because or else if I cut it when it's really cold, it'll split and I won't have these beautiful little squares. And I kind of am one of those uniform, love everything to look the same kind of gal. So again, these are great. These do not have to have parchment paper on the back to store. They don't really stick to one another. They dry pretty well, but it is absolutely delicious. These are, I mean, so addicting. I just love to have these on hand. And I know that I can tell when I go a day without eating them, because I don't feel as good. And just things just don't go as smoothly. It's just an amazing thing about our bodies. I think that we know what works for us. And if it does, and I'm so excited for you to try it, you're gonna love that little snack. Okay, another thing that I love to have on hand is gorp, or homemade trail mix. And again, this is so simple to do. My son happens to like Cheerios, not a big fan, but I like gluten-free cereals. So things like Rice Chex and Corn Chex, I like those, and they don't have as much sugar. And so grab anything you have on your shelf, a cereal. I like nuts, seeds. I like to do dried mango, pumpkin seeds. I have peanuts in here, cashews, whatever makes you happy. But they're great, just put them in a little snack bag. I have a bunch of these in my pantry. So whenever we go out hiking or somebody needs a quick energy snack, this is what they grab, and it's so great. And so I love knowing that these are on hand. So it just takes a little bit of preparation. It just takes a little bit of thought to say, you know what does my family love and what makes sense? Stick them in your car. You know, I remember sometimes picking up kids and they were grumpy and thinking, you know what, they just need some food before we get home or else there's not gonna be a pretty situation. So I would just grab one of these out of the glove compartment and give it to them, and they were great. So it works really well. Okay, another thing, and you probably are more experienced than this, some of you, than I am, are nut butters and nut milks. Now, I'm not gonna go into nut milks because there's so much online about nut milks, and you can make your own, and it's very simple. You know, when you buy nut milk in store, it's like 90% water. So that you know that you're really paying for very little nut, but a lot of water. But when you make your own, especially if you're buying your nuts in bulk, then you can ensure that you have just the right texture and consistency, and it's natural and it's great, and you can have it fresh all the time. And nut milk can last well up to a week, 10 days in the fridge. So I want to talk about nut butters, because nut butters are one of my favorite thing. And of course you can go to Whole Foods and have it ground, and that's an easy way to do it. But if you want to be rotating your nut supply and you want to have maybe different combinations, then you can do that too. And it's a super, super simple process. All you're going to do is you're going to take your nuts, and you can either do one nut or a combination of nuts and seeds. You're gonna put them on some foil on a roasting sheet and put them in your oven at 450 for maybe 15 minutes till they're nice and toasty. And that's all you have to do. You take them out. If they have skin, for example, almonds, you're gonna put them in a tea towel and just kind of roughly shake them like this to get all the skin off. Then you're gonna take them, collect them, put them in your food processor. That's it. You don't have to add anything. A little bit of salt if you want. Now, if the texture of your nut butter is too thick, all you do is add 1 or 2 tablespoons of coconut oil. And of course, a super healthy fat, really energy boosting as well, really good for so many things, your brain, your joints, everything. And you can just put that in, it'll just be the creamy consistency that you want. If you want chunky peanut butter and you've done your nuts and it's really creamy, all you need to do is just throw in some chopped nuts, and there you go, you have your chunky. And so it's really yummy. And these can last in your fridge up to 6 months, which is great. Have any of you tried hemp seed butter? Hemp seed butter is so good. And hemp is so high in protein. And again, has those omega-3 oils. So it's a great thing for you to try. You can add in things like dried bananas or honey or cinnamon and really kind of jazz it up. So it tastes almost like I don't remember what the brand is. Anyway, it's a honey peanut butter. Justin's honey peanut butter, and I pay like $7 for a tiny little container. Well, I can make it at home for 50 cents, a dollar. It's so much less expensive, and it tastes so good and so healthy. One of the things that I love about hemp seed is that you can use it as I'm thinking the vegan direction because I'm not a meat eater. So I like to have an alternative for Parmesan cheese. So what you can do is you can combine equal parts hemp seed. It's a little white seed and it looks kind of green for those of you who aren't familiar with hemp seed, but you can combine half and half hemp seed and nutritional yeast. Sometimes it's called brewer's yeast, and then you can just mix it all together and it tastes, I'm telling you, like Parmesan cheese. We use it on popcorn all the time. It's so yummy. So you kind of have this crunch and this cheesy flavor. Yeast, I don't know why they call it that because it tastes nothing like yeast. It looks nothing like yeast. It's delicious. It's like bright yellow. Or you can use it on toast, like toasted with a little bit of butter or garlic and roast that in your oven. Or you can use it on pasta or on salads. It's yummy. It's just crunchy and cheesy and you've got to try it and you're going to be hooked for life. It's really good. Okay, so now we've talked about nuts and seeds a little bit. I want to talk about one of the most power boosting foods out there, and that is dates. And again, I'm going to rave about this brand. This is Terrasoul. Dates are really expensive at Whole Foods and at Sprouts. I spend $8 on a tiny little box that's maybe half a cup or one cup of dates. But these are incredible. I get three of these big bags and I think less than like $15. And they're so good and so soft. So I would encourage you to look at this one. They already come pitted, but they're super high in fiber. Dates are so good. Let's say that you've gone a long time before you eat between a meal and your blood sugar is really low. I happen to love to fast. And so I find that breaking a fast is really tricky. But when you break a fast, one of the best foods that you can eat are dates, two or three dates. And the reason why is because it brings up your blood sugar level really slowly. And that's what you want. You don't want a huge spike. You don't want to eat bread after a fast or cake or dive into those, you know, enriched foods. You want to have something that really, you know, gets that energy going very slowly, but really good for you. So these date balls, these are again in the ebook that I'm going to let you download, but these are so yummy. They're also rolled in hemp seed. You can kind of see what that looks like. But there's all kinds of different combinations that you can use. The base is always going to be dates. Now, if you're not familiar with dates or you don't like the texture of a whole date or maybe even the taste of a whole date, what you can do is you can soak the dates overnight and then you can put them in your food processor. Even with a little bit of lemon, they're really good with lemon. And then you just have a paste, it's kind of like a butter, and you can use that as jam or on pancakes or in cereals. And it's a great sugar substitute, an all natural sugar substitute. I throw dates in my shirt all the time when I go biking because they are instant energy and they feel so good. So dates, you might not know, are a really great antidepressant. They also help with night blindness. So if you have that issue, you may want to start eating dates every day. They're really good fiber, so it's great for your digestion and for your colon health. They are great for your immune system, so it's a good immune booster as well. Now, when I make these date balls, again, grab the food processor, get your dates. You don't even have to soak them. I grab dates, cashews, some lemon juice and lemon peel. Again, we learned how to make those really easy just in our freezer and throw them in for things like this. And I just throw them into the dates. I add some coconut, some chia seed, and then I process it all really well. The exact ingredients are in the recipe book I'm going to let you download. And it's going to be kind of this chunky, sticky mess. So what you're going to want to do is just wet your hands, your fingers really well so you don't get super sticky. And then just go in and shake the balls, roll them around, and then dip them in or just kind of roll them around in some hemp seed or even flax seed. And the hemp actually is just kind of pretty, or you can even do sesame seeds. And then put them in an airtight container or a plastic bag. These can be easily frozen. In fact, they're really yummy frozen. And they don't even get rock hard. They're just that nice, chewy, cold texture. But it's sweet, and it's got that little zingy of lemon and coconut. It's just delicious. So consider making date balls as well. They're really, really good. Okay, oh, there's just so many more energy boosting foods, and I'm gonna leave it for another time because I don't want you to get overwhelmed, and I just today wanted to focus more on nuts and seeds and dried fruits. But there are all kinds of energy boosters like leafy greens and different fruits and even different vegetables that we can infuse into our diets, coconut oil. Those are all so good for us, but I'll touch on those at another point. So just as a recap, and before I announce what we're talking about next week, I just wanted to go over kind of the four things that we talked about. First of all, deciding what it is that your family loves. What are the foods that they love that are in the energy boosting category, and how can you infuse those, whether that's you know, overnight oats or chia puddings, whether that's frozen protein drinks or whether it's over or oatmeal packets or any of these sesame crisps or nutty bars or date bars. Decide the things. Maybe you just want to try a couple. And I would encourage you to do that. Try a couple of recipes and see what works for your family and what they love. And then make that kind of your thing. Try it for a month and see if it becomes a habit. Because I promise you, if you can think ahead and if you can organize yourself in a way that those ingredients are always on hand and they kind of become your, you know, your family's favorites, you're going to use them again and again. And I think, again, the best way to learn anything for yourself is to share it with someone else. And I would encourage you, if you enjoy the recipes, to download the recipes and share them with a friend or with a neighbor. So next week, we're going to be talking about Buddha bowls. And Buddha bowls are one of my absolute favorite nutrition in a bowl. I mean, it just makes you feel so good to eat one. So we're going to talk about where Buddha bowl comes from and how you can really boost your nutrition every day with a Buddha bowl. I'm going to also give you a refresher on the pressure cooker, because the pressure cooker is going to help you with your Buddha bowl venture. And you're going to learn, again, I know so many of you are already using pressure cookers, but this is going to teach you just the very basics and also how to stock your fridge full of yummy, you know, grains and beans and all kinds of things that you can make these Buddha bowls with, vegetables and all of those things. So if you have pressure cooker questions ahead of time that you want to send me so that I can cover those in the class, I'm happy to take those. And it's going to be a great one. So stay tuned. We're also going to be talking later in the, well, I guess it's almost June, so in June, about how to eliminate food waste and what we can do about that. Also, how to leave a legacy for your family. These are all topics that I'm going to bring to you and I'm so excited about. So thank you to all of you who joined today. I'm so excited for those of you who are going to be watching the recording. And I appreciate your support. If there are topics that you want me to cover and research for you, I'm happy to do that. I always love to share what I learn. So I hope you have a wonderful Memorial Day weekend. Enjoy your families and have great activities and get in the kitchen and make these energy boosting foods. I hope you enjoy it. Until next time, friends. Bye-bye.